Ultima Thule by Mac Reynolds.
Recording by Alice Marty.
Part 1. At least he'd got far enough to wind up with a personal interview. It's one thing doing up an application and seeing it go onto an endless tape and be fed into the maw of a machine, and then to receive, in a matter of moments, a neatly printed rejection. It's another thing to receive an appointment to be interviewed by a placement officer in the Commissariat of Interplanetary Affairs, Department of Personnel. Ronnie Bronston was under no illusions. 9 out of 10 men of his age annually made the same application. Almost all were annually rejected. Statistically speaking, practically nobody ever got an interplanetary position. But he'd made step one along the path of a lifetime ambition. He stood at easy attention immediately inside the door. At the desk at the far side of the room, the placement officer was going through a sheaf of papers. He looked up and said, "Ronald Bronston, sit down. You'd like an interplanetary assignment, eh? So would I." Ronnie took the chair. For a moment, he had tried to appear alert, earnest, ambitious, but not too ambitious, fearless, devoted to the cause, and indispensable. For a moment. Then he gave it up and looked like Ronnie Bronston. The other looked up and took him in. The personnel official saw a man of averages, in the late 20s, average height, weight, and breadth, pleasant face in an average sort of way, but not handsome. Less than sharp in dress, hair inclined to be on the undisciplined side. Brown of hair, dark of eye, in a crowd, inconspicuous. In short, Ronnie Bronston. The personnel officer grunted. He pushed a button, said something into his order box. A card slid into the slot, and he took it out and stared gloomily at it.
"What are your politics?" he said.
"Politics?" Ronnie Bronston said. "I haven't any politics. My father and grandfather before me have been citizens of United Planets. There hasn't been any politics in our family for 3 generations.
"Family?"
"None." The other grunted and marked the card.
"Racial prejudices."
"I beg your pardon?"
"Do you have any racial prejudices? Any at all?"
"No."